Hello viewers, this is Pankaj Arora from Goods and Services at Network, New Delhi, and you are watching our webinar on the topic grievance redressal and other pre-login features of GST portal. So I welcome you again to this webinar. The content which we'll cover in this webinar will be your tourist guide to visit the GST portal homepage. We will take an overview of the GST portal website homepage, and there are certain pre-login features which doesn't require any viewers to for prior registration or to use their credentials, their password or username to access these features. So we will explain those features which are available to all the viewers of to all the visitors of the website, irrespective of their registration status. And there are certain features like downloads and search taxpayer facilities by which one can view the taxpayer's details and the last 10 returns status by viewing it. And the other topic we will cover is like how to lodge a complaint using the grievance redressal portal, which is available at the GST portal homepage. And we will also explain the other features which are available in the help module, the facilities which are available for a taxpayer and the public in general to use. And at last segment, I will take the questions of the our viewers. So once again, welcome to this webinar. We again proceed. Before going ahead, I must inform you that the GST portal is the website created and designed by the Goods and Services Tax Network. Its URL is www.gst.gov.in. To explain it further, I would like to use the live internet features. So this is the real GST portal website, www.gst.gov.in, and you can view the home page of GST portal. On the top, and you can see certain menus in the horizontal bar like home, services, GST law, downloads, search taxpayer, help and e-waiver system. And in the middle segment, you can view the news, updates, events, which are the major news, the latest updates, which we regularly post on the GST portal website. And there are some popular help topics of which we get regular queries, which are the most common issues faced by the taxpayers and the public in general, which we cover in the popular help topics. And you can get the link once you click the help, one of the help topic, you get access to all the short videos, the user manuals, and the frequently asked questions on those topics. So coming back, there are certain more topics like register now. This will there are links to register and how to find a GST practitioner. So this, and at the end of it, there are certain features about the GST council structure, which we will explain in the in appropriately in this presentation. So to begin with, you can see that they at the right hand side, the login option is there. But in this presentation, we will cover all the features and facilities which are available to the public in general before using any registration number or username or credentials that are available freely on our homepage that are called pre-login features. So one doesn't require to log into GST portal to use or access those facilities. So you can see at the top that there is a menu services. Once you click on the services menu, the other menus, sub menus appears like registration, payments, user services and refunds. Once you click on registration, you can get the sub menus of new registration and track application status. So the first thing a user would like to know that what is the registration procedure, what will be the formalities to cover once one apply for a registration at GST portal. So here I am clicking the link new registration. Once I click the new registration link, it gets me to the page of the new registration. Here I am given the two options, like the new registration, or I want to fill the, I have the temporary reference number. So once this is the format to fill in, once I apply for new registration, here I have to select my status and provide certain essential information. Like I have to select from in which category I want to get registered, whether I want to register as a taxpayer or as a GST practitioner, or I am liable to register as a tax deductor or as a tax collector, or my category of registration is non-resident taxable persons or the United Nations body. So in these categories, I have to select from the drop-down list from the given above, and then I have to enter the legal name of business as mentioned in the PAN, permanent account number, my email ID and mobile number. So once I enter these details and click proceed button, I get the one-time password to validate the mobile number and email ID entered by me. So once I validate that one-time password, which I receive on my mobile number and as well as on my notified email ID, then I get the temporary reference number, and then I can use the temporary reference number option and proceed ahead to get the registration. So here is a quick review. This was a quick review to access the registration link. We come again to the new registration application. Once you submit the registration application online at GST portal, you get an application reference number that is called ARN. So once after submission of application reference number, my application successfully, a viewer can track it on the basis of application reference number. Here he has to enter the application reference number, which he gets after successful submission of the application at GST portal online. So after entering the ARN number and clicking on search facility, one can view the status of its registration application. It provides various statuses that if any notice for clarification or for calling for document has been issued by the tax official, or it is pending with the tax official. So one can search and track the status of its application status. So this is a major facility for the taxpayer, for the applicant to track status of the registration application. The another feature available here is the payment. In the payment submenu, you can see that there are two links. One is create challan and another is track payment status. Once you click on the create challan, these all are the pre-login features. You don't require any username or credentials to use these features. So once you enter the GSTIN, that is your registration, GST registration number, or the other ID, if it has been created by the tax official on your behalf, then you have to enter that GSTIN or the other identity. Then you can proceed and create the challan for payment of the taxes or the fine or penalty, whatever it may be. So this was the another feature. We come again to the payment, and we after generation of challan, and before one gets the CPIN, that is Common Portal Identification Number of Challan, and one can track the payment status on the basis of CPIN, that is Common Portal Identification Number of Challan, and the taxpayer has to enter his GST number and the CPIN, and he can track the status whether the payment has been successfully made. And one can view the challan and view its receipt accordingly. If there are certain issues, like the amount is deducted from your bank account but not reflected in the electronic cash ledger, there's a link to raise grievance under the grievance type grievance against payment. So the other link is the user services. User services are, there are certain quick links given here, like holiday list. Here one can question, what is the relevance of providing holiday list? Dear viewers, holiday list is given for your reference because many portal applications, the time limit is there for disposing the like registration application. There is a certain time limit that within the 3 working days, the registration application has to be disposed of either by acceptance or by issuing a notice for clarification. Likewise, there are other certain time limits which gives a prescribed limit of working days by which the certain action, prescribed action, is to be taken by the officials. So for counting those working limits, you are given the facilities of viewing or accessing the holidays list. Here you can see that once you select the 2018 and you select the holiday type, if you fall into the jurisdiction of central government or in any state, suppose we take here the example of Assam, suppose you are registered in Assam state tax department jurisdiction, then you click on search and you get a list of all the holidays, of the notified holidays of that state. So by viewing this, you can ascertain how many days your application, which are the non-working days, and in how many working days your applications is expected to be disposed of. So this is the application list. You can collapse or see it individually or for any month, like I am displaying on this. So coming back to holiday list and going to another features, there is a cause list. This is a relatively new features. We are integrating it various authorities like authority for advanced ruling, appellate authority for advanced ruling, appellate authority under section 107, and divisional authority. And we are integrating and we are connecting with those authorities. In the near future, you can easily access the cause list of those cause lists issued by those authorities to ascertain when your case is lined up for hearing. So this is the link for the cause list. You just have to select the type of authorities, the jurisdiction, state, and the date for which you are accessing the cause list. And another thing is there to search office addresses. So the functionality to search office addresses is there. We are working on it. You can select the state, category state, and select the state and enter the PIN code. And there is one feature, like you can select which zone you fall in and address and ward you select. And after entering the CAPTCHA code, you can get the address detail of the offices you want to approach or access for your work. So another feature in the user services is you can lodge any grievance or if any issues you are facing while working on the portal during submission of any application or return, then you can select it from the drop-down list. Like this, the menu contains complaint against grievance related to processes or application, complaint against registered taxpayers, registered person, entity, grievance against the ledger or register, or if it is related to payment like GST PMT 07 or others category. Once you click as category, the next page opens up to describe it under various submenus. So you will have to enter the check from the submenus, like I have selected grievance against ledger or register. Now the submenu opens up with me whether it is discrepancy in electronic cash ledger or electronic credit ledger or electronic liability register. With this selection will help me help desk to identify the issue and take corrective action accordingly. So in other columns, I have to enter my details like GSTN number, the name and address of businesses, my name, email address, and mobile number. And in some cases, I have to mention if I don't have a GSTIN number, then I have to enter my permanent account number for reporting my issue or the grievance. So anyone can raise any query or the problem which is being faced while accessing the portal in submission of return or any application at the portal, then one can use this facility of self-service portal. Link is there. I will further explain it in later part of this presentation. And there is one link to inquire status of the of the complaint. So once you successfully submit a grievance on the portal, you get a ticket number. Ticket number, you can self-raise a ticket number for it. And you can track the status of the grievance. So like I raised a complaint yesterday, now I have raised a ticket number. Now based on the ticket number, I enter that ticket number here. And enter the CAPTCHA code. Then I get the status of it. So coming again to the next feature of pre-login feature available at GST portal website, I can, if I want advance, I apply for any advance ruling. So whether I am a registered person or if I am a resident or non-resident, there's a link for applying for new registration for advance ruling. I have to register it while applying for advance ruling. First, I have to register it. If I am a resident, I'm a resident person, then I have to enter my detail and give my permanent account number here and enter the other details like name of authorized signatory, email details and mobile number and my address details. And once I click on proceed after entering the details, I get a ID through which I can pay the fee for getting advance prescribed fee for getting for applying for advance ruling, which is a prerequisite for applying for advance ruling. So in case I am a non-resident, in that case, the PAN number is not an essential requirement. Only the essential requirement is that the authorized signatory which is applying for advance ruling must have a PAN and he can enter his PAN in the application details here. So these are some of the pre-login features which are available to the viewers on portal. So again, if there are many instances that one person would like to have to avail the services of provided by the GST practitioners. So in that case, to locate the GST practitioners in your area by the name, by entering the name or area or enrollment number, that is GSTP ID, a feature is available. One can view and track the GST practitioners in his area and avail his or her services. In this link, you can see that here, if I want to search from the area, I can select the name and area. Here, if I don't know the name of GST practitioners, I just select the state or district in which I want to avail the services. Then I have to enter the PIN code. Then on clicking on search option, I get the whole list of the GST practitioners which have their workplace or reside in that area. Or we can search according to the area, or if I have enrollment number of GST practitioners, I can search accordingly. So you can see that I have searched for, suppose I have one GST practitioner ID, then I can search his details. It details comes up and with the his full address, email details and mobile numbers. And likewise, we can avail the services of the GST practitioners and locate the GST practitioners in our area. This is just for the demo only. The other major link we can access is GST law. So here you can get the links of the websites of Central Tax Department, that is CBIC, or various union territories and state tax departments links, website links are there, and you can get access. Suppose here I select Assam, and this will take me to the website of Assam Commercial Tax Department, and here I can access from the under GST menu, I can access the state GST Act or the rules or the various amendments or circular or notification issued by that respective department. So coming back again to this, another feature is the offline tool. Offline tools are different. These are different facilities provided to the taxpayers to prepare that return in convenience of his office without using the internet facility. And once you are done, you are prepared and satisfied with the enter details, you can create a JSON file and then upload it online using the link given at the return dashboard. And there are in the offline tools, there are 14 type of offline tools available in this, which includes the returns, some certain returns offline tools, which is for GSTR 1, GSTR 3B, GSTR 4, 6, 7, 8, and 10 respectively. And there are 4 offline tools for accessing it, for the ITC forms, which are ITC 01 to ITC 04. So 4 utilities are for preparation of these ITC 4 forms. And subsequently, you can submit it on portal. Apart from it, 2 functionalities, 2 download facility, in the download features, 2 offline utilities are there for TRAN 1 and TRAN 2 for the eligible persons to prepare their TRAN 1 and TRAN 2. Apart from it, there is one link for GST ARA 01, that is application for advance ruling. One can get the offline link for preparation of that application. And after preparing it in offline mode, one need to upload it through the link given. So this was the certain download features. Now another very important feature is available is search taxpayer facility. So it is a very good facility, not only for the taxpayers to know the details of the other persons whom they are transacting business, but also for the general public to know if they come across a tax receipt, to know and verify the details given on the basis of the GSTN number or PAN number. So once I click on search taxpayer facility, there are 3 menus. Like one can search by using the GSTIN number, one can use on the basis of PAN number, one can search the composition taxpayers who have applied for composition scheme or who have opted out of composition scheme. Now I will explain this feature. So the search taxpayer facility is provided. Suppose I have a GSTIN number. So based on that GSTIN number, I enter that GSTN number here. And enter the captcha. I get the details of that taxpayer. You can see that it against that GSTN number entered, it gives me the legal name of business, the jurisdiction of state and center where that taxpayer falls, the date of registration, his constitution of business, the taxpayer type is regular or composition or whatever the tax category in which it falls, or GSTN number, it is active or canceled or surrendered, whatever it is. And it also gives us the statuses of up to 10 numbers of last return filed. So I get the return status of the return of GSTR 1 and 3B GSTR 1 statement and 3B return filed by that taxpayer up to 10 numbers in the past. So this is very important facility to check and verify the details of the any taxpayer. You can search the details by using it GSTN number. So another feature is one can also search by on the basis of PAN number. So once for demonstration, I'm using this PAN number. So once I enter a PAN number and I enter CAPTCHA. I get all the registration details which on the basis of that PAN a person has taken throughout India. So in this case, I can see that on the basis of that PAN number, two registrations, one in Uttar Pradesh and one in Delhi has been taken by that person. So there is a link below that GSTN number, and on clicking on that link, I can get the details of, once I enter, I can get other details of like a composition, the address, the jurisdiction details, and last 10 up to 10 number returns statuses of that selected taxpayer. Another thing is, if one want to check whether any taxpayer has opted in and or opted out of the composition scheme, there is a one has to select from the, suppose I have selected opted in. If I have the GSTN number, then I can select it from the features given here. I enter the GSTN number, enter CAPTCHA code and click on search and I get the details. If I don't have it, suppose, and I select the state, and suppose I select state of Goa, and here I have to give that legal name and enter that CAPTCHA. If I don't have the legal name and I, after entering the CAPTCHA, I click on search. Then I get the whole list of all the taxpayers who have opted in for the composition scheme in that particular area. This is various, it can get to various pages of that list. So this was the search facility. Now the other very useful feature is the help feature. So in help feature, first submenu is systems requirement. So once you ascertain the system requirement, because while accessing the GST portal and doing your work on it, specified compliance work on it, you need to ensure that the system you're using meets out certain essential requirements which are given in the here in the website, in the help menu, in the system requirements. There are three type of requirements. The system requirement for accessing the GST common portal. And if you are using a digital signature certificate, then the certain help material is given there. What are the system requirements for usage of digital signature certificate that is called DSC, and how to download and install the WebSocket installer that is called mSigner. So this will be very useful for the persons who are using digital signature certificate for signing their application on portal. So another feature is, very important feature is that we have deployed all the user manuals, frequently asked questions, and short videos, which help you not only to know the nature of the form you are filling in or return, you want to submit. It can suppose here you can see that on filing of returns, on GST offline tools, on registration aspects, as well, not only as a taxpayer, but also as a enrollment as a GST practitioner. For applying for advance ruling, we have different menus in the help section. We have deployed the user manuals and as well as the frequently asked questions, along with certain short videos, which enable you to understand in very simple terms the major processes you have to do while performing at GST portal. So how to authenticate using DSC, sign or EVC, how to view the tax-based dashboard, how to make payment, how to view the various ledgers, electronic cash ledgers, electronic credit ledgers, or the liability register, how to view, how you can view, how you can apply for refund. It is given, suppose I am clicking on it, and it describes various use cases of applying for refunds, and it elaborates, suppose I select a refund of X on account of export of goods. Once I click on it, I see on various submenus that refund on account of export of goods with payment tax, or filing details, export details in table 6A of form GSTR1, which is essential requirement. I am provided with the user manuals and frequently asked questions links for that. Once I click on the user manual, I get the step-by-step process document for compliance of the same. So this is the user manual for that refund use cases, which I accessed at GST portal. So coming back again, so this is the help menu. Like you, like while accessing, like when applying for refunds, you can apply for registration, and you can see that in our category, there are certain short videos. These are the short videos to help you while you apply for registration. Likewise, in the other segments also, we have deployed many short videos, which explains the portal processes in very easy and systematic manner, and that is very easy to understand. So in training kits, like you can see, there is a video, how to apply for amendment of registration as a normal taxpayer, what are the different type of amendments you can do, which type of amendment will require the approval by the tax authority, and there are certain type of amendments and registration details which doesn't require the any approval of the tax authority. So this is the elaborate help section, which covers the user manuals, videos, and frequently asked questions. I urge all the viewers to please make sure that you go through these user manuals and videos and frequently asked questions related to your area of concern, so that you can face no challenges, no problem while working on portal. And you are able to self-resolve your issues. So another thing is, there is one guide for what are the documents required for registration. Suppose the category wise, suppose these are the new registration application. Based on my category, suppose I register for tax deducted source, what will be the document, type of document which is to be attached by me online in my application? This describes the type of documents. Another major link is for accessing the e-waivable portal. So you can access the e-waivable portal directly or through the link given at the GST portal also. So it will take you to the page of e-waivable system, where various legal and procedural guidelines and documents and relevant circulars are there, rules are there to for e-way bill compliances. And you can click here to go to the e-way bill portal page also, which is ewaybillgst.gov.in, and you can log in and generate or view or take other functions on the e-way bill systems. So coming back again, now we have seen ki what features are available in the horizontal menu. Now as I elaborated, if we organize certain webinar or a timeline of a return is changed, or there is another type of an important announcement, we regularly post it in our news or updates section. So you are advised to please check on these news and update section. We post certain important advisories for troubleshooting and troubleshooting tips regularly on the basis of feedback received from the taxpayers. So there are certain popular health topics which we which one can access to get help on the topic of his interest or concern. Another thing is important date segment is there, which covers the timelines for submission of various type of returns. We regularly update it based on the relevant notifications or the circulars issued by the government. So another thing is, in the help menu, you can see that one menu is GST media. So once you click on GST media, you are taken to the YouTube channel of Goods and Services Tax Network, like you are seeing it here. You are viewing here the homepage of YouTube channel of Goods and Services Network, and we are regularly posting certain short videos, like here you can see that how an unregistered person can file application for advance ruling. This is the latest video we have deployed on YouTube channel. And apart from it, we are organizing webinars on different portal application aspects, and you can watch and view all our webinar recordings which webinars we have conducted so far. You can view and watch all the recordings of all our webinars once you click on the YouTube channel of Goods and Services Network. You are advised to subscribe our channel and click on the bell icon to get the regular updates of the deployment of new videos. So in the later part, one can see that it gives information about GST Council structure. A write-up is about the evolution of GST, and there are some features regarding website policies. We have revised our website policy, which you can view on the website policy segment, and there is related site segment where you can access the Central Board of Excise and Customs website and other state and union territories commercial tax department websites, state GST websites. And there is one sitemap which gives you about all we have on our GST portal. It gives you all the information about what is where at our GST at is available at GST portal homepage. So the help desk, how to approach the help desk, because many taxpayers, when they face any type of issue or problem, they try to contact the help desk on phone number, which is 01204888999. But many a times the lines may get busy. So to ease this process, we have you can see that you can log or track your issues without depending upon the phone call. You can yourself log or track your grievance, your issues, by using the self-service portal. We have given a link here, like grievance registration portal for GST. So once you click on that, it takes you to the self-service portal or grievance redressal portal. you are advised, the taxpayers are advised to use this, because this will make you independent of any call. You can select. It is very user friendly. Yeah, whatever issues or complaint you are facing, you just have to use certain keywords for that. Suppose I see here, I type here registration. If I'm facing certain registration, then you can view that. Once I type the keyword registration, it gives me a full list of registration related issues to help me understand my issue and specify it correctly. So I may have to choose it from the drop down list, or there is a quick guide. Once you enter the keyword related to the issue, you have to type that issue in the text box available, and that on the basis of that keyword, certain terms on frequently asked terms will, suppose I enter here refund. So if my problem is related to refund, all the commonly asked issues, commonly reported issues will get reflected here in the drop-down list. If it appears in the drop-down list, then it is okay. Otherwise, I may, if it is now, suppose I select a drop-down list, then another category to further specify it. Suppose I have selected refund not received. Now this will further give me insight on which type to elaborate further my details. So which type of refund I have not received, I have to specify. I can check it and specify here. So suppose I get key, I did not receive the refund due to TCR. So it will further give me another process of subcategories, whom to choose, what not to choose. And based on my choice, it guides me to certain frequently asked questions so that I can access. Like you see on your screen, once I type registration, it gives me FAQs if it is related to my problem. I can watch these FAQs and ascertain if it solves my problem. Otherwise, if I am not satisfied, it doesn't cover the FAQs, then I click on no, I want to log my issues. So here I want to log my issues. I have to, the another page opens up and it gives me it. I have to enter the details, ask, then if I'm a taxable person, then I have to enter the GSTN number, or I may raise my queries or grievance by entering the respective application receipt number or the temporary reference number TRN. So once I enter that TRN and gives my details like name, mobile numbers, and the describe the issues, I have given a text box here where I can explain my issue in 500 words. So, and further to explain my problem, I can attach the screenshots of portal screen where and how I, what problem I am facing. So that screenshots I have to attach. And then after attaching the screenshots, I enter the CAPTCHA code and I can submit my grievance. And by submitting the grievance, a portal, a self-service ticket is raised at the portal. Suppose I enter here as payment. So you can see that all the commonly asked queries relating to payment are reflected in the drop-down menu. Suppose I check here that duplicate payment made, category payment, duplicate payment. Here one FAQ is there, payment regarding duplicate payment. So it gives me the access to the commonly asked questions, how to resolve the problem. If on going through this document, my query is resolved, then there's no need to go further because my query will be resolved. If my query is not resolved, in that case, I have to raise a ticket. And by raising that ticket, I have to note it down and I get a notification regarding the ticket number on the portal app, on the portal, on my mobile number and email ID, and I can track that, the status of that ticket on the basis of my ticket number. So here's the link for checking the ticket or issue details. So you can see that ticket reference number I have to enter here. And once I enter the ticket reference number and enter the captcha, it gives me the present status, whether it is open. Open means it is being worked upon by the relevant authorities. And if it is closed, then I might have received the response on my notified mobile number or email ID. So here we come again to the GST portal main homepage, and you can see that links are given to access the social media channels of Goods and Services Network. The links given are here for Facebook page of Goods and Services Network, the YouTube channel and the Twitter account. So we are here. We have a Facebook page in the name of GST Systems India, and we regularly update it with various troubleshooting tips and the new functionalities posts. So once you so you can view our view and subscribe to our YouTube page, and also we have a Twitter account. We have Twitter handle in the name of Ask GS Tech, where you can get all your technical queries or problems. You can report us on Twitter on our handle AskGSTech, and we will get it redressed, and we regularly post it on the new functionalities and the webinars and the other important events on our Twitter handle. So you can follow us on Twitter on our handle AskGSTech, and this is GST portal homepage. Pre-login features described by me today in this webinar. So I again come back to GST portal homepage. We have toured and saw what are the various features and facilities available here for GST portal homepage, for which anyone can access. And one doesn't need any credentials to avail the facilities or those features options. So it's all. I hope this webinar has been very information provided in this webinar has been useful to you. And with this, I again request you to subscribe to our GST portal homepage. And with this, I again thank you all for watching this with keen interest and patience. And I must thank you before closing. I must thank you for the immense support and help and inspiration provided by Mr. Prakash Kumar, CEO GSTN, Mrs. Kajal Singh, EVP, and Mr. Rajiv Agarwal, SVP. And my training team colleagues, Mr. Veer Singh, Mr. Sateshwaran, Ms. Neera Tamta, and Ms. Rekha Tarawat, for their support and help provided to me in organizing this webinar, and Mr. Manish and my IT team for their help and support, and मिस गरिमा भूमिका भूमिका चावला एंड मिस्टर शोलू राव ऑफ डिजिटल इंडिया विच हैव प्रोवाइडेड हु हैव प्रोवाइडेड दिस वंडरफुल प्लेटफॉर्म टू फॉर दिस वेबिनार टू रीच आउट टू यू एंड थैंक यू डियर व्यूअर्स फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वेबिनार थैंक यू जय हिंद थैंक यू